Yeah, you know, funny enough, we needed a lock in Kimberley. He wasn't in the UK then, and he came and played for us. And so when I was back at the Sharks, and Deacon then mentioned that they need a lock, and straight away Ackers shot up there in the radar. And to make a long story short, he joined us again.
Yeah.
And just a fantastic man, you know. He's a man of God. He's just a solid, solid man. He's a... I'm much older than, but I believe with coaches, it's good if one is a bit older and the other one younger. You know, it's a nice sort of system that you can build up. Yeah, so he offered me the job. I was then, I had a cushy job down there at the Sharks, I thought, and he offered me, said, "Swys, Gauteng, are you ready?" I said, "No, forget Gauteng. I'm a Durban boy kid." And yeah, but then thinking about it, discussing with the family. What a challenge to try and get the Lions back into Super Rugby, down and out. I arrived there and 21 players. I said, "Ackers, where's the players?" He said, "No, 21 left." Mm. There's 21 of the squad that they gave them the option. We're not in Super Rugby.
Oh,
are you going to stick or go? And most of them went. So the guys that we had left were the real McCoy.
Yeah.
It was the guys who wanted to be there. Not all of them the best. There were good ones, like Alvin Hollenbach, who's been in the system, and Ross. Cronier, but then we got, and Warren Whiteley from us was there. Then we started getting a Franco Mostert from Julian Redlinghuis, Warwick Tecklenburg. It's all these players that the other unions didn't want. Skosan, what an asset we got there. The boykie from Brackenfell.
Yeah.
You know, he said to me, "Coach, I want to be here. You'll see, I'm so quick, I'll score tries." I said, "Then you got to come." So we started gathering all these guys from all over the show. So it is a wonderful story that. You know, that we were down and out. So what a challenge. And I must say it, I'm so, so blessed that I could be part of that whole story, how we got there.
What was the philosophy on Swys? Because everybody then goes on to say, you know, the Lions have revolutionized how attack is viewed in the South African context.
I think it was a blessing in disguise, firstly, that we had a year out of Super Rugby to really install my attacking principles that Ackers wanted. Mm. He said, "I'll get the pack going if we can use it."
Mm.
You know, and that was sort of the agreement. And then how we worked on fundamentals, how to get the quick ball going, to see the five spaces, to ID, how to play and not to play. We played against Russia and that tested some stuff. We played in the Vodacom. And the team just sort of grew from that. So the philosophy we adapted was with the kind of players we had, Jaco Kriel, Warren Whiteley, those guys who love to run on the edges, that we got to play fast.
Mm-hmm.
And then the pressure was sort of off that we said we want to play for two reasons, to thrill our spectators and our friends, and sort of almost frighten our enemies by the long distance tries we score.
Yeah.
So when you play against the Lions, you must know everywhere they can play quick, they can start running, they can have a go. And that sort of almost became a DNA of the team.
Yeah.
And we had a lovely bunch of players who became brothers, and the brotherhood, small little things, man, like if you bring water on the field, if the guy brings the water on, you don't take it yourself, I give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
Just to show that brotherhood. And if we sit in the bus, the so-called senior guys would say, "You guys sit first where you want to sit."
Mm.
You know, it wasn't that thing of, "I've played 100 games and now I'm the man, you know.
I'm the boss."
Yeah. I'm the boss. So, so if you, I can, we can speak all day about the ethos that developed there. But
I'll call you for a show for that, because I'm very interested in dissecting certain fundamentals that you need to ensure in place as a coach.
Yes.
Because people think that running rugby just happens. As long as you encourage the guys to throw the apple around, it's just going to be in place. There's a lot that goes into it.
Yeah.
But let's just bring Acorn in there. I think he wants to say something.
And I think from the outside, you could see that brotherhood in the team. But I think for me, I just want to find out from you, because the Lions were known as this running team, but you also kicked when it was on to kick.
Very good question.
Because a lot of people think you guys don't kick, you just run everything, and I don't think that's what you guys are about.
I think what you got to understand, if you want to play running rugby, you got to understand where's the five spaces.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, the space around the ruck is the best one, the quickest way to the try line.
Mm.
But if you got to understand the whole time where the wingers are, the nine who's sweeping and the 15.
Mm.
And that we installed a lot to, so the playmakers could understand. You know, Okana, you asked that question. 2016, 17 and 18, we were around about in the Super Rugby, the team that kicked most, number five, yes. six, yes. five, but it was attacking kicks. Yes. It was planned kicks. Yeah. I've got them kicking a very simple philosophy. You only kick for two reasons.
Yeah.
To gain, to apply heavy pressure or to relieve heavy pressure.
Yes.
There is no, you never kick just for the sake of kicking. Yeah. Let's kick and hope and kick and hope. I go dilly. If I sit and I start watching the tennis and I, you know,
yes.